to run some people through here and have a little fun with you and all that stuff. Here's Nick Dauphiné and my banjo man, Derek Vaden. Philip was hollering this out earlier. And this is probably not just because it's an Osborne Brothers song, but it's probably one of my favorite songs of all time. I love this song. It was it was actually the A side of a 45 that came out on Christmas Day of 1967. And they were pushing this song, my favorite memory, and there just happened to be this other song on the flip side of that 45 called Rocky Top. And somebody turned it over and started playing Rocky Top, and the rest is history. Love this song. It's entitled My Favorite Memory.
Once in a life you meet someone who gives the reason for that life and what some love can do. So now I'm armed for troubled times with all.
Rhonda Vincent, everybody. Come on out.
Over you.
This is one of my favorites. We've sung this many times over the years. And
we've done this usually in Gettysburg. One of the funnest workshops ever. I got to do the it was more of an interview, I guess, with Bobby Osborne. And it was there at the Gettysburg on their, they always have the workshops or something, a jam, something in the side tent after, between the shows. And so there it was, I was there with him, with Bobby, and I took full advantage of that, basically to ask him every question that I ever wanted to ask him. And that's recorded somewhere, you can find that. But what I did find in his favorite job is, like, if he was not gonna be a singer, what would he have done? And he said his most favorite job that he ever had was driving a taxi up in I think it was a Columbia, in Dayton. He drove a taxi and he said he loved it. You know, he got to visit with people and you never knew who you were going to see. I found that very interesting.
Damn right.
Bobby Osborne driving it. Can you imagine going from the airport? It's like, oh my goodness, it's Bobby Osborne driving my taxi. Could you sing to us as you take me to my hotel, please? should we just sing, Larry?
Yes. Once more to be with you. Oh,
Well, he's here. That's the one that got all the high league stuff started for the Osborne brothers. We want some good stuff right there. Red Allen. Hope you enjoyed that old song once more. Lonnie, you got another one in here? And we'll get the man himself up here. How about that?
Did you ever already do Benicio del Toro?
No, haven't.
Do you know what Bobby wants? We don't want to sing a song again.
I have no clue.
Do you think he would do that? Okay. Well, how about Benicio del Toro?
Yeah.
In that good bluegrass key of D. That's a girl's key. D. How's that working over there? I started doing this. Dallas Frazier wrote this song. It was on the Country's Family Reunion. And they said, Dallas Frazier's going to be a guest. Would you pick a Dallas Frazier song? And I said, oh, I know one of his greatest because of the Osborne Brothers. And this is it, Beneath Still Waters. Beneath still waters, there's a strong undertow. The surface won't tell you what the deep
You don't have a dent on me, do you?
I don't like the way he's looking at me. Rhonda got out of here. She's already in the bus.
No, she's gone.
Oh, I got to be on stage with the Osborne Brothers several times. Got to sing a couple times with Sonny and Paul Brewster, and then I got to play guitar on the opera with the Osborne when they started those Tuesday night operas. That was 20 years ago, I guess. I think Dana Cup was playing guitar in the band. He wouldn't come down on Tuesday nights from Michigan to do that. So Sonny called me, and I'm not much of a guitar player, but they liked it. That's all that matters. So I got to play guitar on the Opry with the Osborne several times, and that was always a treat. So I tell people, if you want me to play guitar, it's only on the Opry. That's the way it is, man.
Working with Rhonda, we got to work with those guys a lot through the years, and Tim was up here. We played up in Minnesota somewhere, I think, or South Dakota, North Dakota, middle of nowhere, and Sonny wasn't feeling as good. His back was hurting, and he just was feeling terrible, but he was doing a good job. And, you know, we played a lot with him through the years. Ken Ingram was in the band, Hunter Berry, Josh Williams, and after sound check, we got done. Well, Sonny walks back there to where the record tables are, and we're sitting down. He said, "You boys, get around here right now." You know, he was like E.F. Hutton when he talked, everybody listened. And he said, "I have tried to hate you boys. He said, I want to despise you boys because y'all are so good." He said, "But I just love you guys." And you don't know how much that meant to all of us. He was a big-hearted guy. He was a little bit rough around the edges, but those of us who really knew him, he was such a good-hearted guy. And he liked you. You were a good friend.
I've got to tell you this short story. When I worked with Bob and Sonny, we was here in Jekyll Island, and he said, "Tim, you," and I just went to work with him. He said, "You know all of our stuff?" I said, "Yeah, I know it all." He said, "Okay, we're going to Tennessee Hound Dog." Well, for some reason or other, I had it crossed up in my mind how that song went. So whenever I went into the break of it on the dobro, I completely blew it. And Sonny got to laughing at me. And he said, "Do that again." So I did it again, and it was worse the second time than it was the first time. And there was a guy named Rory Shields here. This was when Norman Adams had this festival. And he recorded everything on tape. So Bob and Sonny, or Sonny, got that tape, and they looped it. So both of those breaks was played back to back, and they played it on the stereo on the Eagle all the way back to Nashville, Tennessee, and sit there and laughed at me. I said, "Man, you guys are cruel." It was an interesting break that I took on Tennessee Hound Dog.
Oh, that song scares me. Hey, John is back here with us on the steel guitar. I'm sorry, John, I didn't mean to ignore you. But give John a big hand for stepping in with us. And for those of you that, I don't know, that maybe are not familiar with the Osborne Brothers music, but do yourself a favor. Get on YouTube or go buy a box set or go get some albums at a used record store somewhere and listen to it. My gosh, it's so good. And they featured the steel guitar and drums and a lot of great instruments for years. Man, it was just the best. Good grief. Rhonda? She's gone again? Now this is a good one right here. Let her have it.
Sing this a million times.
All right. Ready?
In the summer, in the evening, Mama and Papa would sit down on the front porch swing. Me and my banjo,
is here for our folks up here doing the tribute to the Osborne Brothers. What fun has been. What an amazing audience you've been all weekend long. Please be safe as you strike out to reach your destination. And hopefully we'll see you very soon. Hopefully it's 2 weeks from now in Okeechobee, Florida. If not, somewhere down the road in 2023. Once again, a great big thank you to Evans Media Source. And on behalf of Evans Media Source, Evans Media Source sales, and all the staff, the convention center here in Jekyll Island, Georgia, I'm Sherry Boyd. Happy New Year and good night.